My name is Nesuko, and today I will read you another story, Little Miss Scatterbrain. Little Miss Scatterbrain was always forgetting things. Wherever she met Mr. Small, she would call out, "What a fine day, Mr. Tall! Can you believe it? She really was a scatterbrain." On this particular day, Little Miss Scatterbrain went to the clockers. 3 onions, 5 tomatoes, and 2 big carrots, please," she said. "Are you making a soup?" asked the shopkeeper. "Not at all," replied Little Miss Scatterbrain, surprised. "I am making a fruit salad for my birthday." And off she went with her vegetables. What a scatterbrain! And you will never guess what she did next. She got into Mr. Topsy-Turvy's car by mistake and drove off. "Car!" he shouted. "Someone stolen my thief!" As usual, he had got his words the wrong way round. Or was it the right way wrong? And you won't be surprised to know that Mr. Topsy-Turvy's car could only drive backwards. Little Miss Scatterbrain was even more confused than usual. She stopped to ask a cow the way home. "Moo," replied the cow. How very scatterbrain to ask a cow the way home. Mr. Topsy-Turvy went straight to the police station. "A car," he explained, "has taken my thief. You mustn't help me." It took the poor policeman a long time to work out what Mr. Topsy-Turvy was trying to say. On the other side of the town, Mr. Jelly was having a very bad day. He heard a strange noise coming from downstairs, and as you can imagine, this made him very nervous. In fact, he was hiding under his bed, shaking like a jelly. "Home at last," said Little Miss Scatterbrain. "But how old I was, sure my kitchen was green. Never mind, I must get cooking." In the meantime, trembling and shaking like a leaf, Mr. Jelly had made his way downstairs to find out what the noise was. Imagine his shock when he saw a strange figure in his kitchen, a figure with a large sharp knife. "Ha ha ha, help, mamma mamma," he turned, calling the police. "Burglars, bandits, pictures, oh calamity!" "Do not fear, Mr. Jelly, we're on our way," said the policeman. "You'd better come with me, Mr. Topsy-Turvy," said the policeman. "This terrible car might have something to do with your missing car." With stones roaring, Mr. Topsy-Turvy and the policeman arrived at Mr. Jelly's house. Exclaimed Mr. Topsy-Turvy. "Car, sir," said the policeman helpfully. "Pissed the p-p-p-pass. Mr. Jelly to the policeman. Leave this to me, replied the policeman. Happy birthday to me, happy birthday to me, said little Miss Scatterbrain to herself. In the kitchen, the policeman couldn't believe his eyes. Petra's idea, he said, smiling. I should have known that you would have something to do with this muddle. And even less of a surprise, as this is the 1st of April, April Fool's Day. The 1st of April, said little Miss Scatterbrain, very much surprised. Then's not my birthday after all. My birthday is in July, I think, she added. Silly me, but do join me for some fruit salad. Onions, tomato, and carrots with sugar. The policeman wasn't sure he liked this type of fruit salad. Mr. Topsy-Turvy didn't notice how strange it was because he'd put his bowl under his hand. It must be going, said little Miss Scatterbrain to her way. And Mr. Beerman, and off she drive in the police car. Bye, see you later.